And then the last four houses are remaining. So we have Gemini there. Gemini, oh my God, Mars is 0 points.
Yes.
And this, and now here, Jupiter and Venus has 6 points. And that means the Lagnesh is very much interested in this house. And this is one of the reasons she's extremely spiritual. She's very highly spiritual in nature. And now Jupiter is also the third lord and the sixth lord. So as a third, actually the three and nine, these are linked now somehow in Ashtanga. Then the person likes to talk with others about spiritual topics, I have seen. And it happens quite a bit with this girl. Like she's there, and me and one of my other friend, we three, when we sit together. In fact, we were sitting in a restaurant one day, and we were talking about, astrology or some Bhagavad Gita stuff in the restaurant. And that was going on for around 8 hours. From the lunch, we were just sitting there.
Jupiter
And
is also
luckily,
aspecting the ninth house.
yes, that, I mean, that
The
Jupiter is in Digbala, Mercury is in Digbala in the Lagna, so that effects are always there. And this Venus contributing to the sixth house, to the ninth house, can show that the person himself or herself is very much interested. And one of our most common complaints is that my family is least interested. In fact, it's the opposite. What happened was, she had like she used to eat meat, and like a general person. And then 2 years back, when we started, discussing about spirituality, three of us, then she also realized that, it's not very good to kill animals. So she decided that, okay, I will not eat meat. So we congratulated her. We said it's a very great decision. And then after 2 months, she calls me and says that, hey, I had to start eating meat again. Then I
Coming
asked her, why in the universe? Then she told me that I tried my best. I literally am fighting with my family members 24 hours. And I don't want to eat meat. I don't want to eat meat. I don't want to eat meat. I'm doing so much, but somehow I am not able to convince them. And now what happens? Wherever I go, to my relatives or to my friends or wherever, they are just asking me one question. Oh, if you don't eat meat, why are you staying in this material world? You should go to the forest. Okay. So now again, that Mars is giving 0 points there, you see. That means the family is not very supportive of our spiritual practices, or the family is not very much interested there. And now if she says that, okay, tomorrow I want to get married, Mars is also the seventh lord, so this can
Even he will
also,
not support.
yes, and that Mars is again karga for fighting. So fighting can happen for 10,000 reasons, but here fighting is because of, the ninth house. Okay. And again, I mean, Mercury is the third, the ninth lord, and the 12th. So many times I've seen, if the 12th lord has maximum contribution to the ninth house, I have seen these people, once they go abroad or they go to some other very far away place, their spiritual life booms. I have seen that. But here, it doesn't seem to be like that. So here, if she asks me that, I want to do something spiritual, should I go to a distant land? And I would say, well, I don't think it's required. Okay. And now let us go to this 10th house, which has 40 points, the almost the second highest contributor.
Yes.
And if you go to this Cancer, you will see Moon again, 7 points, as the 10th lord. This is great for career. Then Mars again, so that means the spouse will be very supportive of career. We could say that, look here, it's zero and direct seven.
Yes.
So So the husband will be telling her, why are you chanting mantras? Why don't you go to the office?
Yeah, he'll not support her spiritualism. And he'll support
exactly.
Her.
But career-wise, he will support her very much. Okay? And then, I mean, all the big points are there, you know, 5, 7 points, 6 points. And Saturn, I would still dare to bet that Saturn is the king here. Because he's throwing in 6 points, and when he's throwing 6 points, that's insane. So again, the fourth house involvement and the fifth house involvement is coming in the career. So this means this person will most likely get fame from the kind of education which she has had in her past. So if she asks me, should I change my stream of education, I would say better not. Okay. And yes, that's how the 10th house is. And 11th house, again, 44 points. Again, Saturn has 6 points there. And again, this Mars has 7 points. So it's like total support from the marriage for career.
Work-wise, she has total support.
Yes. Work-wise, there is full support.
But then she'll have to work hard also, because Saturn is giving her 6 points.
Yes, that Saturn is always Saturn. I mean, many times people become very happy. Oh, Saturn is giving me 5.6 points, and I'm like, all the best. So that is how. And now we can go to the last house. We see 20 points there, and Jupiter surprisingly is giving 0 points there. So she will be jobless if she goes abroad. 6,000, no job, no daily stuff. Or she will become highly, she will not have discipline. She will become highly, she will just do, she will not have any schedule. You're just getting up, doing whatever you want, whenever you want. Just things are just going on, you see. And again, this moon is again having 1 point. So 10th lord, I mean, no career. It's like you're just roaming headlessly. So again, now see, this Mercury is contributing 6 points. So this will give her a feeling that maybe I should go abroad, you know, for some higher education or something.
Education, yeah. She can do that.
Yeah, she can do that. But again, then she has to come back.
Come back.
The 10th house and the 6th house is not supporting. Now, at times I have seen if the 10th house and the 6th house are not supporting, but suppose 11th house is giving like huge points, then I have seen somehow the person keeps getting money, some grant, some scholarship, some recognition, something or the other will happen if the 11th house is involved. Even if you are not doing anything, it will still happen. But here we can't say that, because Sun is also contributing not that many, he's only contributing 3 points there. Unlike for Leo, he's contributing 7 points, you know. So what is the conclusion for this person? The conclusion is your education and your career will always be linked. That is the first conclusion. For all eternity, it will be linked. And your better not to go abroad for, first of all, better not to go abroad only. That, you say, ask me, should I go at all? But if you see here, Virgo, Venus has 5 points, so she is interested in going abroad. So this is like saying you want to do something which will not benefit you. Okay. But we can tell her that you can go for education, higher education, because Mercury is involved. But better not stay there. Okay. Because if you stay there, then and also another thing here, Mercury and Venus are contributing almost more than half, you see 11. So I have seen if Mercury Venus contributes together to a particular house and has maximum say in that, the person is into party mode all the time, I have seen. So if she asks me, I want to go abroad for studying, well, then I will be like, well, you're definitely not studying there. You're doing everything else. So then, of course, the decision is hers. No, what's yours? And regarding spirituality, the family can pose serious challenges because of this Mars contributing. You know, hardly. I mean, it's not there at all. And for career, there's full support from the family, 7 points. And for finances and also from the side of marriage, it is bit the same because Mars is the lord of the second and the seventh. And medical profession, yes, great, continue. Yeah, so that is what is there in a static way. Now, if you want to see it dynamically, she's running Saturn's Mahadasha now. So when the Mahadasha is running, we can check which point, which places, you know, the Mahadasha Lord has these points. So then we will know which could be the focus area. Okay. So now here you see Saturn has 6 points in the 10th, 11th and in the 6th house, Pisces. So it is full career, nothing else. That is all she wants in this Dasha. And that's how it is. And apart from that, she's running Venus Antara Dasha. So what is Venus telling? Venus is telling, there you see, Venus has some points in the 11th house, and Venus is not saying aggressively towards the 6th, the 10th and the 11th. Okay, Venus has some other agenda also in mind, like the 9th house, okay, like the 8th house. And during this Dasha only, she started learning astrology during Saturn Venus, because the 8th and the 9th are getting active. So now the 8th gets active, but the 9th doesn't get active. This is like saying you have started studying astrology, but you are lost. And the ninth is included. That means you finally come to know. It's like the gain of the 8th or second from the 8th. So then now she can also predict what will happen and you know when. except for herself, she can predict on everybody, of course. So that is the agenda of Venus. And now she will be running Sun after some time, after 2 months, I would say. So then Sun is again 6 points here, 7 points. So Sun is like, again. Now Saturn is like thumbs up, just go on and earning money and forget everything else. And even in Moon, it's the same. You see again, 7 points here, 6 points here. And 6 points in the third house of Sagittarius. So she will again be writing too much, it seems, in Moon. Okay, so yes, that is how we can get an understanding of which are the prominent areas the person will be focusing on or being affected by during these periods using Ashtagvarga. And of course, we also have to check what other things are there. So for example, I was speaking about Venus.
This is very an easy method for people to go through, just on the point basis and the lordship basis.
Yes, so now if you see here Venus, in the Navamsha chart, it is in Digbala there, the fourth house.
Correct.
It is very strong. And Saturn is also in Digbala, Sun is also in Digbala here. Now Venus being in Digbala and it is also with Mercury here, a great friend, and Mercury is also in own sign. So because of this, the Venus Antar Dasha overall was very good for her at a personal level. She had a lot of learning and lot of like in the Lagna, the focus of Venus is on the 8th house and the 9th house. But the Navamsha will tell you what's ultimately happening to her. I mean, just by learning, anything can happen. You know, you may become a billionaire or you may have a lot of knowledge. So now she's ultimately gaining knowledge from all this because fourth house is the house of knowledge. In the Navamsha, fourth house definitely denotes knowledge and it can also denote higher knowledge at times. So that is how we can confirm the results, you know, what the Navamsha is telling. If the Navamsha is telling, you know, Venus is in 10th house, then maybe she takes up astrology as a profession. That can also happen at times. But here it doesn't seem to be so. And she will learn about astrology and Mercury is there. So she will talk with her friends and she will predict who will have a love marriage or an arranged marriage at her age. That's what she is doing now. So that is what we can understand. And Sun Dasha is around the corner after 2 months, and Sun is also in the 10th house, which is again matching with the astrologer description here. So now it's like you are externally into career and internally also you are into career, and ultimately you are benefiting and you are rising very high in your career and name, fame, status. And then Moon is in the Lagna, then you start thinking, okay, I had a big career, blah blah blah, but am I a good doctor? So when Moon starts, she will start thinking about herself because it is in the ascendant of D9. So she will start thinking, who am I? Am I doing good in life? Or no, basically what life is all about. And yeah, that's how we can cross check. Anything else you would like me to say?
Oh, this was a great session. I have to check it on many tabs. Let me
Yeah.
do it. I hope the people we go through it patiently. So
You can also, I mean, share what KP says or regarding these houses or anything else if you wish.
sure. One day we'll do it.
Yes, yes,
Soon.
yes. Okay,
Thank
thank
you
you so
very
much
much.
for your invitation, and we will see each other on KP soon then.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Hope to see you again.
Yes,
It was a
thank
wonderful lesson. And people who do follow Ashtak World, this is something very different we have heard today. How to use the Ashtak World points. Babji really said we just see the number of points and they say, oh, how good this all is. But this is actually how we have to decide. So thank you very much, Babji.
you. Yeah, my pleasure.
See you soon
Yes.
in Mumbai.
Yeah.